I'm going to show you how to send custom emails from a list in Excel. So here I have two emails, and I'm assuming the only example I could think of off the top of my head was somebody who sold cars. And so at the end of the month, they're going to send a congratulatory email to the people that sold cars to. And so in the first field, we have, this is Charlie Brown's email, so obviously fictitious, and Mickey Mouse's email. Then we have the name Charlie Brown and Mickey Mouse. And what they purchased is Charlie Brown bought a 2018 VW and Mickey Mouse bought a Ram 1500 truck. And the terms of the repayment are 36 months for Charlie Brown and 24 months for Mickey Mouse. So let's show you the code. So I'm doing this through Outlook. And I've set e-address as a string, subject as a string, message as a string, Outlook app as an object, Outlook mail as an object, x as an integer, and erow as an integer. The subject is name, purchased, and terms are all strings. So I've defined the erow as the current region row count, so we're just going to how many rows we have in there. And I'm doing a for loop, so I'm going from 2, which I have heading rows, so I started at 2, to erow, and now I have, I'm creating an Outlook application and set Outlook application into Outlook create item 0. Edress is my sheet X1, and then I say, and then all my emails will say, congratulations on your new purchase. That's the subject. And the name is what's going to be in the letter. So it's going to say, so the name is sheet 1 cells X2. So that's there. And purchase, what they bought is the VW right here. If purchased is in X3. And the terms is in X4. And so that's what I have defined here. Now, what I've done in the body, what I've said is congratulations and name. So I've put congratulations then in my name field. And then I've got, this is a symbol for a carriage return. And then I say, thank you for your purchase. And then we have the field purchase that I've entered in that the fourth column or third column. And then I say, we hope the terms are we hope that your repayment and then the terms, which is the 36 or 24 months, will be suitable for repayment. And then I have carriage return. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to call. And then I have the salesman, car salesman as a signature. Now, you could fill in anything here. You could write whatever you want and have your fields that are going to be customized for each email right in there. So then we turn Outlook mail item 2 in the e-address and the subject as subject. And then what I've done here is an Outlook email item display so that you can see it. And I've put a quotation mark in front of the Outlook send so that it's not sending. But when you do it, you can take that off and it will send automatically. Application display alerts true. Set Outlook app to nothing, set Outlook mail item to nothing, and then we're going next to continue our for loop. And then I go end sub. So let's run this and I'll show you what it looks like. So I'm going up here and pressing, let's make sure I'm at the top, and then I'm pressing my run. And so there we have our two emails. So I say, congratulations, Mickey Mouse, for your purchase of the Ram 1500 truck. We hope that your 24 months will be suitable for repayment. And we have your questions, do not hesitate to call, and then the salesperson. And then I have for Charlie Brown, I have congratulations, Charlie Brown. Thank you for your purchase of the 218 VW and the 36 months will be suitable. And same thing. So that way you can send many emails and you can make them all customized from the fields that you have in Excel. I will include this code in my description. Please subscribe.